What is this I hear? Where is this I am? I know who I am. I know who was this I am. Where is this I am?
I'm walking. I walk in power. I walk in miracles. I go to the lap of paper. Cause I know who I am.
But at this point, I would like to believe you get much of him to this point. Get near them, I will get some of them, I will get all of them out of me, because I know what I will get from them.
Ndakaona vamwe vana vakasiyana siyana vachiita zvakaitwa navana baba vavo. Zvino chitsvambe chatinokupai. Ndara vanyora sezvino. Imwe hamba chingakukonesai kuti umwe neumwe anyorerake. Kana ndichafamba ndoda kuti ndigozouya ndozoroja enyu. Handiti chimwe chamungangonungavo sevana kuti isu vana baba venyu navana mai vedu tigotiwo umwe wakatora chipo chake chababa mungakurigwa nomusikana wakaimba akaimba dzipo dzababa vakwe.
We all believe that if you see what is happening in this world, in Christian community, you will see that the church needs to be repositioned. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The church needs to be repositioned. A lot has been lost, which needs to be restored in the church in regard to a real spiritual life of a Christian. Amen. Some of us today, we just take church as a place of entertainment, or it is a place where we go and hide ourselves in there. And if you can call, if you can shout your name, Amen, we all think we are Christians.
Also, John Sharon starts in his introduction. He asserts that God has never forgotten or forsaken or neglected his people, the church. If the believer changes his ways and turn to him, he will restore him to what the devil, he will restore to him what the devil had stolen from him. Now the point is that God is able to restore a life that is stolen from the church. In chapter 1, where he gave the subtitle, The Quest for Revival. In this chapter, he first explains what affects revival. And he goes on to explain what true revival is. Like he quotes, I quote what he said here, a true revival leaves a lasting and enduring evidence of change, progress, and success in our lives and church. As you read this book, you'll see how he develops favor this point in a very captivating way. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So you need to have it and understand why we need to seek for revival, why the church needs to have revival today. Its contents are well placed to suit the needs of the reader. It is all about revival, of which lives that are in revival are required in this apostate generation. The thoughts of the writer are well expressed. A lot of thinking was put into it.
We were brought into the church. The church was unaware. And having come among the beloved, they started to sow seeds of division, seeds of hatred, and that affected the backbone of the church. The church started to crumble. They started to bring ideas that were not promotive of the church's assignment. And in so doing, we find the church becoming weaker and weaker and weaker, year in, represented in the book by Beam of Hope. Beam of Hope in the book represents the body of Christ at large. Then the agenda of those who were brought in began to affect the church. But what do we realize first and foremost? First and foremost, we realize an alliance of the church leadership with other people of a society or a community who are not per se Christians. We are not saying we should not relate, we should relate. But unfortunately, a relationship inoitwa na Bishop Camille Zakaria with the likes of Al Jeremy over the importance of the meeting that the church had organized for both the church and the community. From this point on, they became regular acquaintances. Al Jeremy would regularly call or send some gifts to Bishop Camilo Zakaria. So you see, this very welcome Bishop Beverly, ma'am. Thank you. And all their interactions had no prayer. It was just whining and dining. Because you find at the end, if we can summarize this book, it is calling the church to prayer. It is encouraging the church to come back to the place of prayer. It is in the place of prayer where the church has power. So we find these men becoming quite close. Yet the Al Jeremy guy had a plan. The church was becoming...
See my Lord stands here and you, whom I won't tell where you, dear me, just all, be your safety and you.
Thank you very much. May God bless you all. Life is a journey with problems to solve, lessons to learn, and experiences to enjoy. We get some of these things from the books that you write. Thank you. I remember this cycler who passed
in his work. I am the Father of all life, the King of every good and perfect thing. For in you, God, there is no variableness, there is no shadow of